Now, and we have some incoming information. We're learning there is a third well that could contain potential victims of two convicted serial killers.
KCRA3's Brian Hickey joining us now live with what a Sacramento County bounty hunter has learned from Wesley Shermantine.
That's right. You'll know that Leonard Padilla has been in contact with Wesley Shermantine in prison, getting from him information that has ultimately led to searches that are going on in the Linden area to discover bodies that were victims of Loren Herzog and Wesley Shermantine. Now, what we know this morning is that there are three wells, but as we talk about a third well, it's not necessarily a third well we didn't know about. In fact, it's two wells. Let me show you on a map that Shermantine had given to Padilla some time ago, and this is what we're talking about. Right now, what Padilla believes is this is where the sheriff is digging right now. He says that's a site that wasn't even on the Shermantine map. This is a well that Shermantine indicated would likely have 12 bodies in it. And then up here is the third well we're now talking about. And over the weekend, Shermantine told Padilla that he knows there is a body in that well. So there would be 13 bodies between these two wells that haven't even been dug yet. Why the sheriff's department decided to dig this well first, Padilla does not have any concrete evidence on that or any reason why the sheriff chose to dig there, even though he told the sheriff that, in fact, the well that they should be digging is up the road, up Flood Road. So we are told today that they will be out there digging, but this is what Padilla had to say about his conversation with Shermantine over the weekend.
But the one with the 12 bodies is a quarter mile away. The one that he identified to me on Sunday in a conversation was on the map that he sent me back on the 6th of February. On the 6th of February, he sent me a map outlining what we had already discovered.
And so this is why it's all a bit confusing. And you can see now that the Livecopter 3 is over the area, taking a look at some of these wells that are on the map and where we do expect there to be activity today. We're told the Sheriff's Department will be out there with cadaver dogs, seeing if they can pick up any scent trails. Padilla says he's been out there with his dog, and they've done searches and have confirmed some of these locations. And he is eager for the Sheriff's Department to go out and dig some of these wells. He is thankful that they were able to locate a body in the well that they already dug, but he said this is just the beginning, that according to his conversations with Shermantine, that between these two locations here that have yet to be dug, he believes there's at least 13 bodies. But he said what he would ultimately like to see is Shermantine come out of prison, go out there, because there's about a 25-year span where he's basically going off of Google Maps trying to remember where they may have dumped bodies. Padilla believes that if they took him out there and allowed him to walk the site, they would likely find locations of even more bodies than the ones that we're referring to in these wells. So some big developments in this case.
Hey, Brian, do you get the impression that Padilla is stunned by just the magnitude of what's being found out there as everybody else is?
I think it would take a lot to stun Mr. Padilla, mm-hmm. but, you know, I asked him, why are you doing this? Because some have accused him of being a media hound, and he says, you know what, that's what works, being out in the media, getting people to come forward with information, and so he's simply moving forward with this, and what he wants to find are those other bodies, because he's, at this point, optimistic that they will find these victims and that bring some closure to those families. But what would be stunning is if they found even more leading up to that number of 30 victims that he believes are responsible for.
Well, if you remember, all those calls to the tip line, 100 family members thinking that they have loved ones buried underneath the ground.